There comes a time when time itself is ready for a change. And that time is coming, Montgomery.
Back to the code section. Move.
No.
I am sitting in no man's land. It's not white, and it's not colored. Anybody can sit here.
By my discretion, and I'm telling you to move.
I gotta enforce the segregation laws. It's my duty.
A white person wants his seat.
You go on. You do what you gotta do.
To be in our late, walking my baby back home. arm in arm over meadow and farm, walking my baby back home. We go along harmonizing a song, or I'm reciting a poem. Hours go by and they give me the eye, walking my baby back home. We stop for a while, she gives me a smile and snuggles her head on my chest. We starting to pet, and that's when I get her talcum all over my vest. After I kind of straighten my tie, she has to borrow my car.
Mr. Parks, we have a real chance here to challenge the bus segregation law.
Your wife is smart. She's educated.
You and Mrs. Parks are so well respected in the community.
Well, she's been the secretary of the Montgomery NAACP for the past 10 years.
She'd be most impressive to a white jury.
We've been down this road before, and Rosa is the perfect plaintiff.
Raymond, you have struggled with us all these years. Now here's a chance for some good to finally come of it all.
Ain't no good gonna come out of this situation. Now you mark my words.
Please excuse us just for a moment. Please excuse us. Raymond, I'm asking you to support me.
You're asking? Or is your mind made up?
Both things.
If they ever find out we use the state property
to run
up these
leaflets,
I know.
We will both be fine.
This is our best opportunity to start a boycott, and we're gonna do it.
You discussed this with Mr. Nixon?
Well, not in as many words.
Then we don't even know for sure if there is gonna be a bus boycott Monday.
Oh, now, there will be a boycott. You can count on that.
Give me that baby so you can eat.
You sure won't eat it?
See, the problem is, brother, you're working a little too hard. It's a sermon. It's not some doctoral dissertation. Let me demonstrate this for you. What you do, you get up in front of the pulpit, get a nice look around, see all the people, fill your lungs with a whole mess of air, turn yourself heavenward, and you let that spirit fill you, and then...
Well,
and whatever come flying out, that's what you say.
No, not at my church, not at Dexter Baptist. Folks over there don't go in for a whole lot of hooting and hollering.
Mm-mm, folks at Dexter Baptist are kind of fancy. Now, Rouse Church is...
downright noisy. Rude sometimes. You can't get through half of your sermon without them causing a ruckus.
That fellow Sean Shoes over at the barbershop's member of your church, I think, Ralph. He said, Reverend King, you just should have heard Reverend Abernathy last Sunday. He just preached his you-know-what off. He was just amazing out there. I said, well, what did Reverend Abernathy say? And he said, I don't recall what he said, but brother, we laughed.
What about the ministers?
Oh, Brother Ed, you know our ministers. They're well-fed, comfortable men with good shoes. Ain't one of them ever even been on a bus. Boycott, sir.
We got 2 days to tell every Negro in Montgomery to stay off of the buses. One of them's a Sunday. I don't see how we can do that without the ministers.
Well, hey, young man. Now, take this home here. Nobody rides the buses Monday. Got
bus
that?
Boycott on Monday. We can't succeed unless we have their support.
Hello, E.D. Well, that's very interesting. Boycotts work, Coretta. Worked in Baton Rouge. And Rosa Parks' trial is on Monday. People want to call attention to it.
Now, why are they having the meeting at your church?
E.D. asked. He thought it'd be neutral ground.
Neutral ground?
And we have a nicer meeting room.
Martin, you're a new pastor and a new father. And we agreed that you wouldn't take on too many responsibilities.
But as a pastor, this is part of what I do. just to me.
We came here to talk about boycotts.
So what I think we ought to, I like to make a motion. All right.
The motion is denied.
I didn't make the motion yet.
Well, you were fixing to.
All right.
Welcome to Montgomery, brother.
I'd like to make a motion that we elect ourselves a board.
Denied.
But no, Reverend, I mean, point of order here.
Denied.
Oh, come on.
Sister Robinson, I know how to run a boycott.
He sure does. He's about to start one right now. Folks don't boycott the boycott.
I have a question. How are folks supposed to get to work?
This is no time for questions, man. This is time for action.
I
just want to say we're going to need a leader eventually. And since I have the largest congregation here,
Now look, can we just simply agree for a one-day boycott of the buses? Just one day, just to see what happens. Okay?
Martin. Martin, here he comes.
It's empty.
It's empty.
It's empty. So.
Good morning, Reverend King, Mrs. King.
Good morning.
Very good morning.
Good day for walking.
Yes, yeah. Sweetheart, you might want to go on inside and get dressed.
They gave me this. They said Negroes are supposed to stay out the bus.
If you work, take a cab or walk, but please, children and grown-ups, don't get on a bus at all on Monday.
Swing low, sweet Cadillac,
coming for to carry me home.
Swing low, sweet Cadillac, coming for to carry me home. I looked over Jordan, and what did I see?
Coming for to carry me home.
We got an ambush going.
Based on the evidence presented here this morning, I find you, Rosa Parks, guilty of violating the state segregation statute. And I hereby fine you $10 plus $4 court costs.
Your Honor, Mrs. Parks will refuse to pay the fine and hereby notices her appeal.
Farewell. I'm setting her appeal bond at $100. Pay the clerk.
Folks are going to have to get smart and join the plan.
Order! 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 Now, there's a motion on the floor to
suspend the boycott.
Now, it's too soon to quit now. It's too soon to quit. Huh? Now, we just getting started.
That's right. That's right.
Now, I'll tell you what we need to do. We need to have a little bit more faith in our people and ourselves.
That's right.
Now, we talking about whether or not to end the boycott. Now, that's putting the cart before the horse. What we need to be talking about is electing us a leader to represent us. Then we can go...
He's had his eyes on that seat for a while.
It's somebody to negotiate with the city and present our demands.
That's I like him, though. Old union man.
Crush Lewis, I don't care. I got something to say.
He don't have the
floor.
Now, Rufus Lewis, he's a... which might say a man of the classes.
Now, you ministers have been living off these washwomen for the last 100 years and ain't done nothing for them.
He's a man of the masses.
Let's tell the truth. Let's tell the truth. Let's tell the truth. It's our women who've been carrying the torch. It's our women who've been getting arrested while y'all hide behind their skirts like a bunch of damn cowards.
Brother Nixon, I'm not a coward, and I don't want anybody calling me a coward, but I agree with you. The time has come to stop hiding. Now, Ms. Parks didn't hide this morning before that judge, and we should act openly. Now, as for the question of whether or not to suspend the boycott, well, it seems to me that ought to be left up to the folks who attend that meeting tonight. After all, they're the ones who are going to be doing that walking.
Right. Mr. Jeff. While I respect Mr. Nixon's years of service to the struggle, I feel we need a minister to unite our entire community. I think he ought to be a young man, a strong man, because we know this job is going to take a lot of energy.
Amen. That's right.
Therefore, I nominate as president of the Montgomery Improvement Association, Reverend Martin Luther King, Jr. May I have a second on my nomination?
Yeah, I second that nomination.
Well, thank you, Reverend Abernathy.
You ain't see that one coming, did you?
No, Ralph, not at all.
You the perfect choice. You've been in Montgomery, what, a year? That ain't nearly long enough to make any real enemies.
So you don't think they think I'm the best man for the job? Well,
of course they do. Because if you fail, ain't they ass in the ringer, is it? It's yours.
Who are you anyway? Just some young hotshot preacher from Atlanta, a big old divinity degree from some fancy northern university. You're just an outsider, brother, with a powerful daddy. They'll send you home and be back to business as usual.
You think so, huh?
Uh-huh.
Well, thank you, Ralph. You're
very welcome. You worried about leading this thing?
No, I'm worried about telling this woman.
And what did you say?
I said yes.
You said yes?
I said yes. I didn't ask for it. I just made a few remarks to clarify the situation, and before I knew it...
You were trying to bite off a little piece, and you wound up with the whole pie.
That's more or less what happened.
Let's have dinner.
No. No time. I have to give this speech in an hour, and you know it usually takes me 2 days from a sermon. And now I've only got good luck.
You'll think of something. You always do.
Now, brothers and sisters, today I want you to put on the whole armor of God. The whole armor of God. Against the wrong done against you.
It's Dr. King. He's president of the Montgomery Improvement Association.
This is Dr. King, yeah.
Please tell him, brother.
Don't do it. Dr. King, this is the day we have waited for. It's now all up to you.
Miss, that hold us in high place. And now I introduce to you the president of the newly founded Montgomery Improvement Association, Reverend King.
Good evening.
First,
I would like to thank Brother Fields for sharing his pulpit this evening. And I'd like to thank you all for coming out. You didn't have to do that. But I know you know that we are here this evening for serious business. We are here in a general sense because, first and foremost, we are American citizens. And we are determined to apply our citizenship to the fullness of its meaning. But we're here in a specific sense because of the bus situation in Montgomery. Now, just the other day, one of the finest citizens in Montgomery, not one of the finest Negro citizens, but one of the finest citizens in Montgomery was taken from a bus and carried to jail and arrested because she refused to get up and give her seat to a white person. And you know, my friends, there comes a time when people get tired of being trampled by the iron feet of oppression. There comes a time, my friends, when people get tired of being thrown across the abyss of humiliation where they experience the bleakness of nagging despair. There comes a time when people get tired of being pushed out of the glittering sunlight of life's July and left standing amidst the piercing chill of an alpine November. We're here because we're tired now. And we're not wrong in what we're doing. If we are wrong, the Supreme Court of this nation is wrong. If we are wrong, the Constitution of the United States is wrong. If we are wrong, God Almighty is wrong. If we are wrong, Jesus of Nazareth was merely a utopian dreamer and never came down to earth. We are wrong. Justice is a lie. And we are determined to work together here in Montgomery, to work and to fight until justice rolls down like water and righteousness like a mighty stream.
Nothing wrong with wanting what's right. People around here been wanting what's right all along.
I have here a resolution drafted by Attorney Fred Gray for your consideration. And it reads, be it resolved that the members of the Montgomery Improvement Association will continue the boycott indefinitely until such time as a fair and just agreement is reached. Now, all those in favor, please signify by standing up. God be praised.
Our Negroes did not stay off the buses by choice. We have proof that Negro goon squads are intimidating coloreds that would otherwise go right on riding. I intend to make sure that law and order are maintained, and coloreds that want to go on riding our buses will not be constrained by outside agitators or unlawful elements.
We got people out here who've been walking for 3 days, and we can't even get ourselves together to make up a list of demands.
Look, now, we should ask for the deal they got down in Mobile. There's a precedent for it.
First come, first serve seat.
The city council would have to give us that at least. Write this down now. Negroes from back to front, white folks from front to back.
Plus courtesy and respect for the Negro passengers from the drivers.
When hell freeze over, pardon me, Reverends.
Can we agree?
Now, we need to add that we want Negro bus drivers to service Negro routes.
Robinson, they're never going to agree to that.
Well, we can ask. There's no harm in asking.
If we can't agree amongst ourselves, we're going to waste this opportunity.
They have Negro bus drivers in other cities.
Miss Robinson, you know this is Montgomery, and they're never going to grant us that demand.
Maybe that's why we should ask for it then.
So they can reject it.
Reverend King.
Look, now, we've emptied their buses for 3 days. Not a single Negro has broken the boycott. So they know they have to accept some changes, but now, at the same time, they have to save face. So we offer them an unreasonable provision so they can reject it.
It's not unreasonable.
It is to them, understand?
It's just we have to be willing to give up something.
Give up something? We hardly ask for anything in the first place.
It's a foothold until we can appeal Mrs. Parks' conviction.
Martin.
Excuse me. Could you please not do that?
Oh, Fred, come on.
Please.
Oh, Fred.
Don't ever call this house again.
Who was that?
Nobody.
Well, what did he say?
Nothing I care to repeat. Just words, Coretta. I've heard them before, and so have you.
Martin, this isn't Atlanta. This is Montgomery. And you do not take those words lightly around here.
This will all be over soon. The mayor convened a special meeting tomorrow with the city council. They'll compromise. They have to.
Let me respond to your demand. Point one, first come, first serve seating. We at the Montgomery City Line are subject to the law of the state of Alabama, which, as we all know, requires segregation of the race.
If I may, the Alabama segregation statute states city authorities may require segregation, not must.
Point two, courtesy, respect from the drivers. Now, as far as we know, our drivers are hardworking. Okay.
Drivers are abusive. They physically throw Negro women off of the buses for sitting in an empty white section.
That is gossip.
I've seen it with my own eyes. The buses stop at every corner in the white neighborhoods and every other corner in the colored neighborhoods.
Well, I won't say there isn't room for improvement. Point three, hiring nigger drivers. We won't tell the bus company who to hire, and we certainly won't stand for first come, first serve system.
They've done it in Mobile.
Even if we wanted to, we can't. That would require the abolition of segregation.
Which is a law. Is that what you're asking for?
And other cities throughout the South?
You're not answering our question, Mr. King. Are you and your people calling for the abolition of the segregation laws?
No, what we're arguing for is a more humane system.
Well, see, can you get
I got something to say.
Most of y'all know, most of my life I've been fighting to kill Jim Crow, whether it's be the Union or the NAACP, and I'm gonna tell you one thing. The NAACP will never support what we're doing.
I do not agree.
Reverend King, the NAACP will never support an organization that's only asking for a more humane system. Never.
Now, obviously, I have a great deal of respect for the NAACP, but this is the Montgomery Improvement Association. And the Montgomery Improvement Association has done more in 4 days for Negroes in this city than the NAACP has done in 10 years. Now, I don't mean to be harsh in this, E.D., but we need to move beyond this now. We share the same goals. We have the same aspirations. We just have different ways of going about it, that's all.
The chicken's almost ready.
There's a minimum fare ordinance. Taxis must charge a minimum of 45 cents.
Bullshit! How am I supposed to see? People can't pay 45 cents for no taxi.
People can't pay 45 cents for a taxi.
The drivers were charging a dime, same as the buses.
Which is why they want to raise the minimum fare.
But if the drivers charge less than 45 cents, they're liable to lose their license and their livelihood.
I hope this don't make Miss King jealous, Rev.
People aren't gonna give up their cars.
But
they're too important to them.
Well, I worked in Baton Rouge. The taxis there weren't allowed to lower their fares either. Carpools kept the boycott alive.
Well, that's all well and good, but ain't too many car owners in my flock.
Well, I'll tell you what, Rev. Right. You keep them walking. I'll get us some cars.
Now, I'm hearing stories, inspiring stories. We have Mother Pollard here, 70-year-old woman, walking to and fro to work and back home 12 miles every day with a cane unbent. Now, I feel an unstoppable conviction right now. And I know you feel it, too. So we're going to keep on walking. We're going to keep on walking. We'll walk to work every morning, and we'll walk back home every night. We'll wear a groove in the footpath of our cities. Yes. Wear a groove in the pavement until they see the depths of our conviction. We are not walking, we are marching.
Yes. And he said unto them, which of you shall have a friend, and shall go unto him at midnight and say unto him, friend, lend me 3 loaves. For a friend of mine in his journey has come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. Many in this congregation are very fortunate in their material possessions. Amen. Material things can be very nice. Amen. Many of us have fancy cars, Cadillac cars, and that's all right. Mm-hmm. But now God is calling on us to use these things to a greater purpose than simply to drive along the highway on a Sunday afternoon or cruise through the city at 10 miles an hour to impress the neighbors. We on the committee have decided on a system to ease our burden. Morning, Mr. Sands. His car broke down. We're asking you if you have a car to share it. We're not asking for any outside help in this. We're going to do this ourselves. And we are going to pool our monies from all the churches to share the cost of maintaining the automobiles and the cost of gasoline and such. And here's the good news. Now, we're going to take up a second collection today.
Amen. And I'll tell you something else. If a couple of farmhands get mud on his precious upholstery, old Dr. Johnson's going to have a heart attack on the spot.
Now, you be careful there.
Do you really think that people will just give up their cars?
Well, I've been told I have certain powers of persuasion.
Who told you that?
My beautiful wife.
Thank you.
didn't last in Baton Rouge.
What?
Boycott. Carpool ended in 2 weeks.
We're guessing the bus company losing about 30,000 Negro fans every day. Subtract some for folks who walk, some just stay home. It's about 20,000 people, 20,000 rides a day. That's what we need. Now, with the number of cars we have volunteered, that works out to be about 130 rides a day for every single car.
Every car?
Every car. All right. All of you riding out near Madison Street, you're gonna ride with Dr. Johnson here. Come on, get in. Everybody go on near Madison Street.
Now, you all be careful. Please.
Let's go. Everybody.
Please.
Get in. Dr. Johnson, you still gonna drive, sir? We sure appreciate what you're doing for the cause, sir.
Get ready for the revolution.
Taking us all by surprise. I will bear that in mind. Yes, sir. Good night. That was Mr. Milton.
On the deck of the board?
Yeah. Reminded me that I'm still the pastor of a church.
And did he also remind you that the last pastor was fired for his radical views?
Not in so many words, but it was very much implied.
You found five.
You don't have
God bless you.
Now you tell me you gotta be there at 6 p.m. sharp now. 6 p.m. sharp.
Gas up for one of the 8 Negro filling stations.
7 Negro filling stations.
Oh, Lord. Okay. I'll get back. Got some trouble at the Day Street lot. Vandals done slashed some tires.
They asked us to watch over these here vehicles after some of the tires got slashed. Said we could even sleep at them if we want them, long as that don't happen to them. We gotta do our part too. You understand?
And then you raise the taxi fares by 45 cents.
Car's been analyzed all over town.
Who is this?
The ambulance secretary. Lights.
Is that who I think it is?
I guess he left his robe at home.
Mr. Mayor, we were not informed that Mr. Ingalls was a member of your committee.
I don't think it's our job to inform you, Mr. King.
Well, what is our purpose if certain members have come with preconceived ideas?
Reverend King, I came here prepared to vote in favor of Negro bus drivers. I resent very deeply your statement that we as white people have come here with certain preconceived ideas. I most certainly did not.
Nor did I.
I apologize to those of you who have come with more open minds, but I would also like to state for the record that we of the MIA strongly protest the presence of the White Citizens Council at this meeting.
You're here representing the Negroes. No difference, me representing my people.
Don't compare our two organizations.
Why not?
The White Citizens Council is openly racist.
That is your opinion, Reverend King. Now, I suggest you exercise the same tolerance for a different opinion.
I don't think it's a question of my tolerance.
Well, it seems you got a real problem with other people expressing their opinions, don't you, Mr. King? This man here speaks for y'all.
Let me make one thing very clear. Let there be no mistake that Reverend King is the voice of every Negro in this room. But he's also the voice of 50,000 Negroes in Montgomery.
walk right into that.
Amen.
Now, see, they think they're slick. They're not negotiating on good faith, and they think we're foolish enough not to know the difference.
Brother, this is a siege. This is a battle to see who's gonna give in first. They just wore you down.
I guess you're right.
As soon as you concede even one point to the Negroes, you open the floodgates. They're like children, W.A. You gotta be firm with them.
We're doing the right thing, just waiting them out.
Boycott will be over today. The Negroes will never keep on walking. They do not have the stomach for it.
You smell that rain? Ain't a cloud in the sky.
Good evening. In the year 1619, the first Negro slaves landed in ships on the shores of this nation. Nearly 400 years later, the Negro in America still is not free.
No, Miss Stone and her daughters have been waiting for 45 minutes. You need to send a car over there to Jackson Street right now.
I can't guarantee your car won't get a little bit muddy. Well, it is raining. Well, we will clean your car for you, but we need it right now.
Yet the substance of America is expressed in the sublime words, we hold these truths to be self-evident. All men are created.
Everybody, we need everyone we can get. So we can count on you then? Thank you so much.
Hey, Ben. Yes.
No, the boycott's not suspended. Just a little rain.
Rain? It's a typhoon.
Yeah. All right.
Where are you going?
Well, we need drivers.
About the same as yesterday. Nobody's riding the buses. The boycott held.
Hello? Martin? Hello? Who is this?
To their Negro maids and cooks. They're only prolonging the boycott.
The only reason they help them so they don't have to do their own laundry.
You know, if you really want to hit them where they live, make the cooks and the maids go on strike.
Martin, phone call.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Hello. Hello, hello, Mr. Rowe. Oh, of course, I admire your work.
They think that it's funny that whites who oppose the boycott will act as chauffeurs to the very Negroes that are boycotting.
Uh-huh.
A Negro rider.
Well, no, that's a false rumor. No, I'm quite sure. That's definitely a lie. No member of the MIA met with the city. Well, thank you.
That was Carl Rowan. Lead story in tomorrow's paper says the boycott's over.
Wait, who said that?
No.
Well, according to the story, some ministers from the Montgomery Improvement Association came to terms with the city council.
People read something like that, it could break the boycott.
But they can't just say it's over.
Well, they call it a negotiated settlement.
Negotiated by who? We got us a Judas in our midst.
No. Wait, who's not here right now?
We got 30-some-odd hours to get the word out before the first bus Monday morning.
Everybody don't go to church on Sunday.
Watch yourself.
Now, how do you know about these places?
You do your things, word gets out, you know.
Hey, Rev, where you at, man?
All right, brother. Remember to stay off the buses, okay?
Hey, Rev. You wanna shoot some stick?
So I'll see you in church tomorrow, right, boy?
Damn, you some shooter, Rev.
Y'all gonna play again?
No, that's all right. I think my best pool shooting days behind me, but I appreciate you taking it easy on me.
Wasn't going easy on you. Guess maybe you had some divine help.
Maybe so. You know, I think by the time some of these folks leave out here tonight, the boycott may be over.
Time for church.
That King fella, he's a troublemaker, if you want my opinion.
Don't believe what you read and only half of what you hear.
Who you think it was?
I'm afraid somebody from our borders talking to the city behind our back.
You're kidding me. We got our Judas.
We didn't know. We were summoned by the mayor. They said it was an insurance matter.
Well, so then you never volunteered a settlement on behalf of the MIA?
No, sir. They made like it was something that already been settled. Asked us to sign it.
Well, Reverend, it's vital you make the truth public.
I think it would be to your best interest to do so.
Yes, sir. I could see how that would be.
Well, all right. Good evening now.
Good evening.
Take care. God bless.
Take care.
Now, if we expose this story, we call them the most powerful men in Montgomery liar.
If the shoe fits, where?
But you know, these white folks won't see it that way. Bad enough they cut a deal with a bunch of Negroes, then the whole thing falls through anyway.
That's not our problem.
No, that is our problem. Makes them look weak. In order to look strong now, they got to strike back.
Negroes can get where they're going from the back of the bus.
Sam here sits up front with me all the time. Am I lying, Sam?
The White Citizens Council just got 3 brand new members. Imagine that.
Imagine that.
We believed we had an agreement, but the Negro leaders have betrayed us.
The Negro radicals think that they can force the white people of this community to submit to their demands.
Hey, D, ain't no preachers in here.
They don't really care about better bus service for their people. What they are after is the destruction of our social fabric, our way of life.
And we will.
Show them crackers.
Today, we are over.
You are not going to believe this. 10 traffic tickets. 7 of them for speed.
Miss Ryerson likes to get where she going.
These 3 here are for going too slow, and that's just in the last 2 days. They are ticketing everybody who's riding the boycotts. And believe me, they're not cheap.
Now let them know in Washington, D.C., that we got something going on down here.
Well, this can only end badly for all. This goes to the heart of
Am
our
I?
Life, and they're trying to
yes.
destroy
it. Oh, yes, you can sign up for a ride.
Women, our children.
Well, just leave us your name, and I'll let you know about it.
The mongrelization of the race.
Will somebody please pick up the other phone?
Hello?
And we're asking you to pay the fine yourself.
Not at this time. We can't. Well, we're figuring out a system to reimburse people.
These tickets are going to send their insurance premiums through the roof. There's a provision in the law that allows the state to take action against drivers who are deemed to be hazards. And too many traffic tickets and,
They don't confiscate cars.
They could confiscate their cars.
Tell all my friends that Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. was my own personal driver.
You tell him, sister.
Yeah. Be careful now.
I see.
Oh, shit. Pardon me, Reverend.
That's quite all right, sister. I'll share your sentiment.
Step out of the car. Just him. Martin King.
I done something wrong?
You were doing 30 miles an hour in a 25-mile speed zone.
They write me a ticket.
Shut up. Get up against the car.
He didn't do anything.
What are you doing? I'm arresting you. You get back in the car. Give me your hand.
Don't hurt him. Look, take me with you. He didn't do anything.
Get back away. Step away from my car.
Find Coretta. Find my wife and let her know what happened.
Yes, Reverend.
That first slave ship, you didn't have to worry about whether or not you were sitting in the proper section. You didn't have to worry about getting up to give your seat to a white person. You were loaded into the belly of that ship on a first-come, first-to-serve basis. And any Negro who dared to reject the circumstances under which he suffered, well, that Negro was a problem.
They took him out of his car and he didn't do nothing wrong.
This your first time, hmm? Never been here before.
Well, no, never before.
You see that hook there?
Where?
You know what that's for. 40 days. And he went up and he looked over. But see, you have not yielded to the possibility of the inevitable.
That's not for you. That's not for you yet.
This is a property bond.
Only way to make bails with cash.
This is an accepted form of bail payment throughout the entire state of Alabama, sir.
Not this time of night.
Well, this is an acceptable way.
Take a look at this.
Martin, this is Harry Phillips.
Evening, Robert Phillips.
Evening, okay. He's gonna be your driver.
What do I need with a chauffeur?
Look, we can't have you driving anymore. It just ain't worth the risk.
Come on, let's go on home.
Threaten my family.
Righteousness like a mighty stream, and when the history books are written,
somebody will have to say, there lived a race of people, a black people, fleecy locks and black complexion, who had the moral courage to stand up for their rights. And thereby they injected a new meaning into the veins of history and civilization. And we are going to do that here in Montgomery. God grant that we will do it before it's too late.
I have today instructed the police department to break up congregations of Negroes that are loitering in white residential districts.
The Bible's very clear about the separation of the races.
Animals in the woods don't mix. The fish in the rivers don't mix.
I don't care what the Bible says, what the Bible doesn't say.
This will only lead to a mongrelization of the races.
Furthermore, many local businessmen have promised me they're going to lay off Negro workers who are being used by outside agitators from the NAACP as instruments in this boycott.
Ain't no good gonna come out of this. People getting all riled up.
Well, I'm sorry it happened, but we still urgently need your help. No, you're not expected to pay for it. We have a fund that covers it. Just send your repair bill to our treasurer, Mr. E.D. Nix.
Repair bill? Fine. How much money you got in your pocketbook, Miss Robinson?
Reverend, how long has that police car been sitting out there?
I don't know. Long enough, I suppose. Tell me something. Is your landlord a white man?
Listen, everybody, we're moving out of here right now.
What?
Grab everything that you can get. Get everything out of here.
What's going on, Reverend Abner?
The police are out there, and if they evict us, they get to keep everything in here.
They've got no reason.
They will find a reason. They always find reason.
Where are we moving to?
Anywhere, as long as it's owned by a Negro. Go, 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 go!
It's supporting an illegal boycott.
What do you expect me to do? She has a limp, poor thing. She's lame. She can't walk to work.
Well, what she does is her problem. Now, every time I see you driving her, I'm gonna give you a ticket.
My white lady always be asking me about the boycott, but I don't tell her nothing. Better she don't know. But I will tell you this.
Joanna, we have things to do.
Yes.
The city isn't offering anything more than the same old segregation with increased bus fares. Now, we've walked for months, and I say we keep on walking until our city fathers give us what we're asking for.
The latest proposal by the city now is just ludicrous.
I agree with you. I agree with you. Ladies and gentlemen, now we've been at this for 56 days now.
That's right. Yes,
and
right,
I think the boycott has succeeded beyond our wildest dreams. I do believe it is time for us to be reasonable.
Reasonable?
What is reasonable?
Now let Reverend Banion finish his point, please.
Now, let me tell you what is reasonable. If they give us 2 out of 3 of our demands, I think we ought to.
We see the same place.
Look, it seems to me that were we tonight to tell the people that it's time for them to get back on the buses, we would be ostracized, completely laughed.
Yes.
Exactly.
Yes.
Look, they have had the courage to continue walking. We should have the courage to hold the line.
Right. Hold the line.
Continue.
Here we are trying to lead a movement we can't ever seem to catch up to. Is there some way we can bypass the state courts?
Not with Rose's case, but we could file a separate suit on the federal level
go after segregation on a constitutional ground. I'm waiting for an opportunity like this. The success of boycott might just give us the leverage we need to pull it off.
If we go federal, we're gonna bring down a lot more heat on ourselves, a whole lot.
You can't deny that. If we're asking the federal court to overrule segregation, we're gonna need some additional plaintiffs to strengthen our case. And certain folks might have to put themselves at risk.
So Attorney Gray is drafting a lawsuit demanding that the city's segregation laws be declared null and void.
On the grounds that it violates the 14th Amendment.
Now, which one was that, brother?
The right to equal protection under the law.
The suit will be filed this afternoon.
Are you saying we're going to the Supreme Court or something?
I mean,
Reverend King.
Federal court?
No, it's a separate matter.
Now, you're going to sabotage our negotiations with the city.
The city already sabotaged the negotiations themselves by not being willing to negotiate. Right. I mean, they didn't come to the table in good faith.
Now, that's a declaration of war. You're going to give them reason to kill us.
Well, look, Reverend Banyan, from the beginning, the only thing we have asked for is a modified system of segregation, and they already want to kill us. So it seems to me they leave us with two choices. Either we give in, or we just go on over their heads and rid ourselves of segregation altogether.
Reverend King, you walking out on a very dangerous limb, and you're asking us to go with you.
At this point, our only plaintiffs are women. However, we would like to include some of our men as part of the lawsuit, and at least one minister. A minister has great symbolic value in the community. Now, the Reverends King and Abernathy wouldn't be good choices because they are too much in the limelight.
My grievances are not personal. They're on behalf of my parishioners.
I agree with that.
Will not one of you volunteer? We're gonna have to make this work with the plaintiffs we have. Keep the boycott running, the court's gonna have a hard time avoiding us.
Let's hope.
The Negroes are trying to make this a federal case, but we're not gonna let that happen. We don't want Washington politicians telling us how to run our business and how to live our lives. We have rights too.
This boycott is illegal. Now the Negroes can either accept our final offer or suffer the consequences.
You see, in the belly of those slave ships, it didn't matter whether you sat in the right section or not. You see, you didn't have to worry about getting up to give your seat to a white person. You were loaded into the belly of that slave ship on a first-come, first-to-serve basis. And any Negro who dared question the circumstance under which he suffered, well, that Negro was a problem.
You may be an ambassador to England or France. You might like to gamble. You might like to dance. You may be the heavyweight champion of the world. You may be a socialite with a long string of pearls, but you're gonna serve somebody.
Serve somebody.
I want you to know you're gonna serve somebody.
Comes a time when time itself is ready for a change. And that time is coming, Montgomery. Our opponents, and I hate to think of our government officers as opponents, but that's what they are. They have tried all sorts of things to break us. But we still hold steadfast, resolute. And still, we don't advocate violence. We don't have to.
Amen.
The Lord is with us.
Amen.
And we are a chain. We are linked together, indivisible.
Yeah.
I cannot be what I ought to be unless you are what you ought to be.
Amen.
We are a chain. Now, we have good news in Montgomery right now. Now, how do we protect our feet? We have all kinds of shoes from all kinds of folks from all over the country.
Yeah.
shoes to replace the shoes that has been worn down by us walking. Shoes to help keep us all walking. But we got something else also. I have here a check from our brothers and sisters in Mobile, Alabama for $500.43. They sent a letter with it, I guess to keep us encouraged. They said, please accept this check for $500.43 for your cause and our cause. We here in Mobile, Alabama support your fight. P.S. The 43 cents is to let you know that some more is coming. This new Get Tough policy, this ain't gonna stop us. We all know the state of Alabama's motto. Hard to Dixie, huh? Well, I say, let's keep on walking until Dixie has a heart.
What a day of rejoicing it will be.
What a time, what a time,
what a time. What a look at Jesus will be.
What a time,
what a time, what a time. I'm going to tell them all.
Yeah.
Brothers and sisters, what do? We fight on. And no matter what the other side does, it's one thing that they cannot do, and that is force us back on them buses.
Amen. What is it?
Your house has been bombed, Martin.
Coretta, in London?
We don't know yet.
We ain't going nowhere.
That's right, that's right.
Lord, Lord, thank you, Jesus. When all of God's children, when they get to
Reverend King, I can assure you that this type of activity will not be tolerated.
My boys will look into this. You all right?
I'm all right.
You okay?
She's fine. She's in the back. Both fine.
They ain't going. We are gonna have a riot on our hands.
I promise you a full investigation. We're offering $500 for information leading to the arrest of Donald. I understand your concerns, but there's nothing else to be done. It's time for y'all to go on back to your home.
This is
right.
Our home.
You go home.
What we're fighting for is right. And we're gonna win. Because y'all white folk, y'all don't scare us no longer. And you can't kill all of us.
Yeah!
I thank you all for showing your support. Everybody's all right. If you have weapons, please take them home. We must not meet violence with retaliatory violence. We must love our white brothers, love our enemies. This is what we must live by. We must meet their hate with our love. And God is with us.
Show us Coretta.
You hit somebody with that stick and we all gonna die out here tonight, Jack.
That's right. That's right.
Hell, I know it ain't right to attack a man's family. I know they're angry. I got a job to do.
Let's go. All right, I want that car out of here.
She's all right.
She's all right.
All
right. She's all right. Amen.
Amen.
All right, go on home now.
What a day of healing. Thank you, Father. Nothing but love, joy, and peace. When all God's children have mercy, Father, when we get together. Talking about a time. What a time. What a time. What a time. Thank you, Jesus.
When do we get to fight back? Brother King. Brother King, there are people out there. They want to take matters into their own hands. Fight back. Show them we're not afraid. If the whites bring guns, then we bring guns.
We won't win a battle with guns. They've got more guns. They'll get tired of beating us when they see it won't break us.
Damn it, they don't seem to be getting tired. Seems like they're getting stronger than ever. Seems they like it.
Brother Phillips, we won't stoop to their level. We believe in the Bible.
An eye for an eye, boss. That's in there, too.
Right down the hall if you need anything.
Thank you, Anita. And I don't pretend to understand why you've been chosen. I really don't. But you have. You are the right man.
But that crowd out there, that hatred can't be contained. I'm beginning to question whether it just runs too deep. You or the baby had been hurt, there would have been bloodshed. I want you to take Yolanda and leave Montgomery.
Martin.
Go to Atlanta and stay with my parents until this is resolved.
We are family.
I will not have the blood of my family on my hands.
Don't let them intimidate you.
Woman, they bombed the house. I think they already have.
I got it.
down there.
Daddy King.
Hello, Coretta. Looks like you're doing a little redecorating.
Get called bad. It's good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Safe. You've done important work here, son. There's nobody prouder of what you've done here than I am. But there's no reason you can't run this boycott from Atlanta. You push for too much here in Montgomery, you'll lose everything. Your position, your reputation.
Daddy, I won't leave.
Martin, they bombed your home. You are in peril. Your family is in peril. This city is set to explode. If you're not careful, there's going to be a race war.
I can't walk away. I won't. I started something here, and I intend to finish it.
Coretta, talk some sense into my son.
Baby, what do you want to do?
I'm staying here.
And so am I.
My name is Byatt Rustin, R-U-S-T-I-N. I believe you have a room reserved for me.
Uh-huh. Well, put your John Hancock down there and give me 3 nights in advance, and we'll be in business.
Tell me, how far a walk is it to the home of Reverend King?
Well, I don't know what y'all do up there in New York City, but you don't want to be walking alone down here at night, especially with this bus business going on.
And here I thought all black people walked in Montgomery.
Not at night.
Ooh. I'll take my chances.
But who are you?
Spired Rustin.
What are you doing here? Why'd you come all the way down here from New York City?
It's a business trip.
You here to stir up something with that nigger boycott?
Well, I do intend to avoid the buses.
What kind of business you do at night?
I'm a journalist. I am working for The Figaro and the Manchester Guardian. Those are European journals, newspapers. Is there anything else?
What do you want?
I'm here to see Dr. King.
Need to go on home?
My home is a long way from here, and I don't really care to return to it at the moment, since I just left it to come to Montgomery to see Dr. King.
Reverend King's not seeing any visitors. Now go on.
Nelson, who is it?
Nobody, ma'am. Somebody just leaving. He can come back in the morning.
Good evening, Mrs. King. Byatt Rustin.
Byatt Rustin.
Excuse me. Who are you?
I heard you speak on nonviolence when I was a student at Antioch College. And I will never forget it because you said something about history that has stayed with me.
Is that so? What did I say?
That history wasn't an accident. That history is a choice.
And why did that make such an impression?
Because it means that we can do something about our lives, and we're not stuck with the way things are.
Wow. So now you're down south. Aren't you a long way from home?
No, no. I'm from Marion. That's not too far from here.
Didn't like our northern customs?
Actually, I did. Quite a bit.
Well, if Bayard Rustin is here, then I guess we've arrived.
Dr. King, I wouldn't miss a moment that's going to change our country forever.
Yes, yes. So a policeman says to him, says, well, can you describe these turtles? And the snail says, no, sir, I can't. It all happened so fast. Well, see, that's how we feel. Here we are, 77 days into a one-day boycott.
You've managed to sow the seeds of Gandhi in the soil of the South.
Well, it's not just about Gandhi. It's also about the teachings of Jesus Christ.
Mass action and black social gospel. It's a new form of protest. Yeah. I mean, it's Negro. It's jazz.
Well, whatever it is, it's taken us all by surprise.
Might just take the whole country by surprise. That's why I'm here. Evan Kane, I'm gonna be blunt. You're straying from the principles of nonviolence.
In what way?
You're the leader of a nonviolent movement. And yet you have guns in your home and these armed guards outside.
Let me ask you something, Mr. Rustin. Would you risk your family for a tactic?
Nonviolence is not a tactic.
Would you risk your family?
Nonviolence is an ideology.
I have an obligation to protect my family and defend my
religion.
Well, the guns don't make me feel any safer.
Look, the movement is in its very early stages, and I hope with all my heart that it remains peaceful.
Peaceful change is healing.
There is a very definite possibility of violence.
Reverend, I didn't know
After
you were...
Tonight, I want you to find a safe place to put that.
The boss.
School officials later suspended Authoree Lucy for her own safety after she and her NAACP escort were surrounded by angry white students. Democratic presidential candidate Adlai Stevenson, speaking to a Negro audience, suggested that only gradual means would satisfactorily settle the school crisis and other problems affecting equal rights for all Americans. More on that story later. And now the weather...
One Negro girl admitted into college. That's about as graduate as you can get, I think.
They forgot the part where they throw eggs at her.
Well, now you see. It's not just about Montgomery anymore. And it's sure as hell not just about seats on the bus.
Bayard Rustin, ladies and gentlemen.
It happens whenever an oppressed group finds its voice. The white man. Some white men are terrified that if the Negro ever attains power, he will act without pity to revenge the past.
Damn right.
We have to show them they have nothing to fear.
The bus company's hood. They're on the verge of bankruptcy and are now willing to meet our demands, but the city won't let them.
We forgive everything. We have to bring the message of nonviolent resistance to the rest of the South. Everything you've learned here, we have to teach the nation. It's your responsibility.
There's also a rumor. The city might bring indictments.
On what charge?
They dug up some old Alabama anti-boycott law.
We know the people here. We know. They'll walk forever if they have to.
You've got to stop thinking about this as just a bus boycott. It's not. And you cannot win this fight unless there are similar protests all over the South and similar protests all over the nation. It is in your own self-interest, your own.
Have you ever run a bus boycott before?
Not buses, no.
Well, then why are you lecturing these people?
The same principles are at work.
What makes you think they need outside advice?
And who might you be, sir?
Emma Jackson. editor of Birmingham World.
Well, welcome, brother.
Just want to talk to you about your affiliations.
Well, that was a long time ago, Mr. Jackson.
This I want to hurt. I want to make the bastards pay.
I understand that.
Reverend King, I ain't like you. I am not like you. I am not a non-violent person by nature. Now they've attacked my homes and I want to strike back. I don't know if I can do this. We march and sing and plot and plan, and so they can blow up our homes, they blow up your home too.
Y'all just gonna sit there. See how they be?
A lot of notes in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 39 reads, but we are not of those that shrink back unto destruction, but of those who have faith to the preservation of the spirit. I believe that.
Sorry.
No doubt that man is a leader. I just don't know where he's leading us.
We are Christians. If you must stone them with forgiveness. If you must stone them with love. Through these powers, we will discover to our wayward brothers the error of their ways. This is and will ever be a non-violent movement.
Take care, yeah? The folks up at Fisk want me to come up there and speak.
I'm not surprised.
But I can't just leave here and go up to Nashville.
Martin, it's time. You have to get the message out. If you don't go national, you're gonna lose locally.
Now, Coretta, it's another thing entirely for you and Yoki to stay here alone while I'm in Nashville.
So we go to Atlanta, and then what?
Many of the Negroes who joined the protest did not expect it to last this long. When asked why, they usually gave one of three answers. Didn't expect Negroes to stick to it. I never thought Negroes had the nerve. Or I thought the pressure from the white folks would kill it before it got started. Our nonviolent protest in Montgomery is demonstrating to the Negro that many of the stereotypes he has held about himself and other Negroes are not valid. Something is happening to the Negro. He's come to feel that he is somebody.
Got rope, got trees.
These indictments brought by the grand jury should not come as any surprise. We are committed to segregation both by custom and by law, and we intend to maintain it and to protect our way of life.
They got arrest warrants for everybody on the committee. All our organizers, everyone in this room, 115 of us. It's the largest mass indictment in Alabama history.
They're trying to chop the head off the boycott. Yep.
So what's our response? Well, we don't really have one yet. Now, Reverend King's up in Nashville.
How long is it going to be till they start arresting us?
As soon as the deputies get the warrants, maybe tomorrow?
Probably. It's what I'd expect.
Well, I would prefer not to be arrested at the college. Don't want my students seeing that.
All right, I'll tell you what, brother. You figure out a way to keep us all out of jail, we'll find a way to get you some salvation.
Amen.
Yeah, I'm on my way now. I'm going to stop in Atlanta.
Hi, Reverend.
To kiss Greta and the baby, then I'll be there tomorrow afternoon. Mm-hmm. Well, that seems to me that's just a scare tactic, Graham. Yeah, that's the same old thing. Mm-hmm. Well, you do that. You do that. You keep it together. I'll see you tomorrow, yeah?
Make no mistake about it. The only reason that they're doing it is to try and separate us from Martin. That's what this whole thing is about.
Reverend Abernathy makes a good point. But there's a larger issue here. What is a jail? It's just a building. Bricks and steel. That's all it is. You're the ones who give it power. You've got to lose your fear of jail.
I just want you to consider the consequences of returning to Montgomery. The police there are targeting you. I have that on good account. You can't lead a boycott from inside a jail.
You can't lead a boycott hiding out in another state either.
Young lady. There is a larger picture to look at.
Yes, there is, and I'm surprised that you're not seeing it. I'm leaving tomorrow.
They will arrest you. They're arresting everybody.
What are we supposed to do? Just go turn ourselves in?
What happens to the boycott?
If we turn ourselves in, we admitting guilt as if we're criminals.
You got that backwards, Reverend. It's the criminal who hides. I ain't got nothing to hide. I ain't no criminal. I ain't afraid of nobody's jail.
You have a wife, a daughter. You ought to be thinking about them.
That's exactly who I am thinking about.
At least tell your wife to stay here with us.
No, I can't do that. I need her.
Listen, Martin, this is serious. There's a rumor that they're about to arrest Bayard Rustin for lying about who he is. And I got this from Emory Jackson, who got it from some white guy over at the paper.
Well, I ain't been looking for an outside agitator.
Now they got one.
And brother, this could ruin us. They can turn the whole movement into some communist plot.
Some things have come up that we need to discuss.
I know.
You know, I used to think that the Christian ethic of love was only confined to individual relationships.
It's what we are. It's what we breathe.
Yes, yes.
We need to be going.
Those things they say about you.
There's nothing they can say about me that isn't true. I'm an ex-communist. Ex-con. I'm a Negro. I'm a bastard. I'm a homosexual. And I don't have a proper job. I'm a man of my times. But the times don't know it yet.
a gift, Martin, plain and simple.
What, spiriting you away in the middle of the night?
No, returning their violence with nonviolence. You mark my words, tomorrow a spotlight will shine down on Montgomery, one that will galvanize this country.
You'll be safer in here. Are they looking for you still?
Maybe I'd be better off in the back of the bus.
Thank you, Raya.
Griffin, it's my pleasure.
Well, like you said, it's not just about buses anymore.
As I look at it, I have committed three sins. The first sin I have committed is being born a Negro. The second sin I have committed, along with all of us, is to object to the twin battering rams of segregation and oppression. The third and most basic sin which all of us have committed is having the moral courage to stand up and express our profound weariness with this oppression.
You looking for me?
It is one of the great glories of America that we have the right to protest.
I believe you looking for me.
This is not a war between the Negro and the white. This is a conflict between justice and injustice. You see, most people see nonviolence as a cowardly or weak thing. It is neither cowardly nor weak. It is perhaps one of the bravest forms of confrontation known to man. We are using moral and spiritual force. This is all we have. We are using the weapon of love.
We who believe in freedom cannot rest. We who believe in freedom cannot rest until it comes. We who believe in freedom cannot rest. We who believe in freedom cannot rest until it comes.
Until the killing of black men, black mothers, sons, is as important as the killing of white men, white mothers, sons. We who believe in freedom cannot rest. Touches me most is that I had a chance to work with people, passing on to others that which was passed on to me. They have the courage where we fail. And if I can but shed some light as they carry us through the gale.
The Supreme Court decision on segregation is now law. There is a motion on the floor to end the 13-month-old boycott of public transportation in Montgomery.
All those in favor, let it be known by...
We who believe in freedom cannot rest. We who believe in freedom cannot rest until it comes. That which touches me most is that I got a chance to work with people. Was passed on to me. We believe in freedom.
Coming, brother?
No. You all going ahead.
Don't you be afraid.
A lonely noise. The sun is sinking, cause it's got no choice. Just like my sinking heart.
What you